also want to point out that we have a major, major, major generational problem. All the polling I've seen, ADL's polling, ICC's polling, independent polling, suggests this is not a left-right gap, folks. The issue in the United States' support for Israel is not left and right. It is young and old. And the numbers of young people who think that Hamas's, massacre was justified is shockingly and terrifyingly high. And so we really have a TikTok problem, a Gen Z problem, that our community needs to put the same brains that gave us Taglit, the same brains that gave us all these other amazing innovations, need to put our energy toward this, like, fast. Because again, like, we've been chasing this left-right divide. It's the wrong game. The real game is the next generation. And the Hamas and their accomplices, the useful idiots in the West, are falling in line in ways that are terrifying. Last thing I'll just say, we saw a dramatic change in the language of the activists here in America on October the 8th. The language of groups that we've long tracked, long been problematic, like Students for Justice in Palestine and Jewish Voices for Peace, they flipped like this and went to like Iranian propaganda. The language I could show you from their toolkits, because our analysts are in their groups. We saw this again on October the 8th. It was that fast. Like, the language in their toolkits was all about the Zionist entity and lots of other language that we recognized from Iranian propaganda.